Welcome to Abiding Presence for a celebration of divine worship for the fifth Sunday of the Christian year. Our celebrant is Bishop William R. Cavins. Our Mass intention is for all pregnant women. Our gathering song is number 790, Come Worship the Lord. Please stand.
We are his people, the flock that he shepherds. Alleluia. Come worship the Lord, for he is his people. The flock that he shepherds. Alleluia.
Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
And also with you.
My brothers and sisters, as we gather this day, we are mindful of our sins and transgressions against the Lord. Let us call to mind then his mercy and forgiveness and ask for his pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault in my thoughts and in my words and what I have done and what I have failed to do. I ask the Blessed Mary, your Virgin, and all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. God, the Father of mercies, has reconciled the world to himself through the death and resurrection of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and sent the Holy Spirit among us for the forgiveness of sins. Through the ministry of the Church, may God grant us pardon and peace, to absolve you of your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Give to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of our Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen, amen. Let us pray. In faith and love, we ask you, our Creator, to watch over your family gathered here. In your mercy and loving kindness, no thought of ours is left unguarded, no tear unheeded, no joy unnoticed. Through the prayers of Jesus, may the blessings promised to the poor in spirit lead us to the treasures of your heavenly kingdom. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. Amen. Let us be attentive.
A reading from the book of Job. Job spoke, saying, is not a man's life on earth drudgery? Are not his days those of hirelings? He is a slave who longs for the shade, a hireling who waits for his wages. So I have been assigned months of misery, and troubled nights have been allotted to me. If in bed I say, when shall I rise? Then the night drags on, and feel restlessness until the dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle. They come to an end without hope. Remember that my life is like the wind. I shall not see happiness again. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
your name forever, O King and our God.
For your pages I keep you mindful, Lord, and your hands shall lead me from my feet. This has been all the glory of your name, and declare your might, O God.
I will praise your name forever, my King and my God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if I preach the gospel, there is no reason for me to boast, for an obligation has been imposed on me, and woe to me if I do not preach it. If I do so willingly, I have a recompense, but if unwillingly, then I have been entrusted with a stewardship. What then is my recompense? That when I preach, I offer the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my right in the gospel. Although I am free in regard to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so as to win over as many as possible. To the weak, I became weak to win over the weak. I have become all things to all to save at least some. All this I do for the sake of the gospel, so that I too may have a share in it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. On leaving the synagogue, Jesus entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with a fever. They immediately told him about her. He approached, grasped her hand, and helped her up. Then the fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening after sunset, he brought to him all who were ill. They brought to him all who were ill or possessed by demons. The whole town was gathered at the door. He cured many who were sick with various diseases, and he drove out many demons, not permitting them to speak because they knew him. Rising very early before dawn, he left and went off into a deserted place where he prayed. Simon and those who were with him pursued him, and on finding him said, "Everyone is looking for you." He told them, "Let us go on to the nearby villages, that I may preach there also. For this purpose have I come." So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout the whole of Galilee. The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. May the words of the gospel wipe our sins away. throughout the world today. Many are suffering. The pandemic has wreaked havoc with the health of many people, the lives of many families, the economies of the world. And we happen upon these readings today that speak of suffering. When we look at Job, he sits there and he laments because he was placed at the test. It's a contest, if you will, between good and evil. And many misfortunes endured in his life from the loss of his family, his position, his wealth, to become nothing. You hear of his despair as he talks about how he lays in bed at night, not really wishing to rise, troubled. We hear of the illnesses that affect Peter's mother-in-law. And we could relate to our own circumstances, including that of mental illness. So what message does the gospel give to us today? And here is where we wish we understood Greek, or that we heard that gospel reading in Greek. In the Greek translation, as Jesus helps Peter's mother-in-law, it tells us, it uses the word to help her rise, or to arise. And when you look at the two words in Greek between arise, or rising up, and resurrection, you can see the tie. That Jesus not only healed her, but that he was helping to resurrect her spirit, to bring her to life again. And then the English translation is, she went out and took care of them. She fed them, prepared a meal. But in the Greek, they actually use the term diakonia, to serve at table, which is what our deacons do. The order of deacons. So we hear that Jesus, as he's healing, is raising people up. He's giving them hope for a new life. Suffering is something as we endure in life. But in Christ, we have hope for a better life, where there is no illness, there is no sadness, but there is only a life of joy. And he gathers his apostles around him, and they go out to these villages to preach that gospel. Paul tells us he has a responsibility to preach. He has to become all things to all people so that at least some of them could be saved. And that is just not the responsibility of the ministerial priesthood. What we sometimes fail to grasp as Christians is that there is only one priest. And that is Jesus Christ. And he has given to people like myself ministerial priesthood that we share with other priests and deacons so that we can go out and give the good news, to preach that gospel of hope and love to others. But you see, there's another priesthood as well that you and I share in. And that is that once we were baptized, we became priest, prophet, and king. As chrism was placed upon our heads, we were transformed into Christians that have that responsibility. So it is not just that the responsibilities of bishops, priests, and deacons to go forth and let people know what God has done for us. It is all of our responsibilities. As we go about this day, about this week, let us all look for opportunities to alleviate suffering and illness in the lives, in our own lives, in the lives of our family and friends, and in our community. And if we are all doing what we are part of to do, or we are charged to do as Christians, then slowly that love of God builds out from us to our families, to our communities, to our states, to our nation, to the world, so that we are all transformed in Christ. Let us profess our faith by reciting the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Just as Jesus' ministry was sustained by prayer, we offer in Christ's name our own prayers and needs and the needs of others to a God who loves us.
Our response is, Señor, óyenos, grant our prayer.
Señor, óyenos, grant our prayer.
For the church, that all the baptized will strive to live and preach the gospel in their daily lives, Lord, we pray,
Señor, óyenos, grant our prayer.
For those in authority, that they ensure the religious freedom of all people under their authority and act to promote racial equality among all citizens, Lord, we pray,
Señor, óyenos, grant our prayer.
For an end to the COVID-19 pandemic, that people in all nations around the globe work together to end the pandemic, taking care to meet the needs of poorer countries and vulnerable peoples. Lord, we pray,
Señor, óyenos, grant our prayer.
That throughout our nation, there will be renewed energy to understand and undo the wrongs of the past, build a future of partnership and collaboration. Lord, we pray,
Señor, óyenos, grant our prayer.
For all faith communities, that they will be enlivened by the Spirit, that they will work together to develop a sense of mission and turn it into action. Lord, we pray.
Señor, óyenos, grant our prayer.
For people with no sense of purpose in their lives, that through the grace of the Holy Spirit, each of us gathered here now will be bearers of peace, consolation, and hope to the downhearted and those without a sense of purpose in life. Lord, we pray.
Señor, óyenos, grant our prayer.
The sick and those in danger of death, may they be comforted by God's abiding presence. Lord, we pray.
Señor, óyenos, grant our prayer.
for those for whom we grieve, that they be at peace in the loving arms of Christ. Lord, we pray.
Señor, óyenos, grant our prayer.
For our own needs, for those that stand in need of prayer and have no one to pray for them, for those who've asked our prayers, especially those we remember now. Lord, we pray.
Señor, óyenos, grant our prayer. Saving God, we ask you to answer these prayers so that we will be faithful, we will faithfully proclaim your gospel and eagerly do your will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The offertory hymn is number 723. There is a balm in Gilead.
Brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all the church. Lord our God, may the bread and wine you give us for our nourishment on earth become the sacrament of our eternal life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
All-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. All things are of your working, all times and seasons obey your laws. But you chose to create humanity in your own image, setting us over the whole world in all its wonder. You made us the stewards of creation to praise you day by day for the marvels of your wisdom and power through Jesus Christ, our Lord. We praise you, Lord, with all the angels in their song of joy.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power, God of might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Yes, Lord, you are holy. You are kind to us and to all. For this we thank you. We thank you above all for your Son, Jesus Christ. You sent him into this world because people had turned away from you and no longer loved each other. He opened our eyes and our hearts to understand that we are brothers and sisters and that you are creator of us all. He now brings us together at one table and asks us to do what he did. Father, we ask you to bless these gifts of bread and wine and make them holy. Change them for us into the body and blood of Jesus Christ, your Son. On the night before he died for us, he had supper for the last time with his disciples. He took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread. He gave it to his friends, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In the same way, he took a cup of wine. He gave you thanks. He handed the cup to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me."
Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
God, our Father, we remember with joy all that Jesus did to save us. In this holy sacrifice, which he gave us as a gift, which he gave as a gift to his church, we remember his death and resurrection. Almighty God in heaven, accept us together with your beloved Son. He willingly died for us, but you raised him to life. Jesus now lives with you in glory, but he is also here on earth among us. One day he will come in glory, and his kingdom, there will be no more suffering, no more tears, no more sadness. Almighty God, you have called us to receive the body and blood of Christ at this table and to be filled with the joy of the Holy Spirit. Through this sacred meal, give us strength to praise you more and more. Lord, remember the patriarchs of the East and of the West, me, your unworthy bishop, and all other bishops. Help us who follow Jesus to work for peace and to bring happiness to others. Bring us all at last together with Mary, the Mother of God, and all the saints to live with you and to be one with Christ in heaven.
Through Christ, with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Creator, forever and ever.
United as one family in Christ, let us pray as Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from all sin and anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, my peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us share with each other some sign of peace. Peace be with you, Jean. Peace be with all of you at home.
Peace be with all of you.
This is Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to this supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body and blood of Jesus Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Our act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. The table is prepared. Come, eat, and drink.
Our communion hymn is number 576, O Healing Light of Christ.
Healing light of Christ, transform us, life-giving source of hope. Oh, healing light of Christ, transform us, heal your people, Christ our Lord. Light as strength of the body, eases and comforts the troubled mind. Radiant light that stirs our spirits, radiant healing light. living light of Christ, transform us, life-giving source of hope. O healing light of Christ, transform us, heal your people, Christ, our Lord. Your hearts of compassion, your desire for hands that heal, your light of pathways that all are caring, you are healing heart. The healing light of Christ transforms us, life-giving source of hope. O healing light of Christ, transform us, heal your people, Christ, our Lord. His praise through all of creation, known as the flower and warms the heart. Yours is the light that breaks through the darkness, through our healing light. The light of Christ transforms us, life-giving source of hope. O healing light of Christ, transform us, heal your people, Christ, our light.
Our hymn of thanksgiving is number 579, Your Hands, O Lord, in Days of Old.
Let us pray. God, our Creator, you give us a share in the one bread and the one cup and make us one in Christ. Help us to bring your salvation and joy to the entire world. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you for joining us today. Just a few things in our bulletin to bring to your attention. You can find a copy of our bulletin on abidingpresenceministries.com. Check on the bulletin link. Our Lenten regulations. Ash Wednesday and Good Friday are obligatory days of fasting and abstinence for all Catholics. In addition, Fridays during Lent are obligatory days of abstinence for persons ages 18 to 60. Those that are excused from the fast of abstinence outside the age limits, including the physically or mentally ill, including individuals suffering from chronic illnesses such as diabetes. Also excluded are pregnant or nursing women. In all cases, common sense should prevail, and a person should not further jeopardize their health in fasting. The traditional fast for Catholics is very simple. It is one meal a day that has meat, except on Fridays, when you don't eat meat. And then the other two meals should be more like snacks and nothing in between meals. There is no restriction on liquids. Next Sunday is Valentine's Day. So at the end of Mass, we will be giving a blessing to all married couples and all engaged couples. So please spread the word and invite people to tune in with us on Facebook or Zoom. We are still looking for a donor to cover the cost of a Paschal stand for our ministry, for our chapel. There's information on that in the bulletin if you would like to give it in honor of someone. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and each other. Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn, number 866, For the Healing of the Nations.
For the healing of the nations, Lord, we pray with one accord. For a just and equal sharing of the things that earth affords. To revive the love in action, help us rise and pledge our word. Help us rise and pledge our word. As forward into freedom from despair or world release, that redeemed from war and hatred all may come and go in peace. Show us how through care and goodness, fear will die and hope increase.